Today's webinar. And today we're going to be talking about getting started in scouting. We went over this last week a little bit, but we have some new tips and tricks and some new, just some new things we're going to share with you today. And so let's get started here. But first, of course, like we do on these webinars all the time, we go through a little bit of the latest and greatest news around the Cascade Pacific Council, and we'll talk about some of the upcoming events, and also sometimes on these webinars, we'll have some topics with experts and little Q&A at the end. But today we're going to just go over some new tools and things like that we have for you, for new scouts and new parents who are joining us this year. Boy, so many parents around the Cascade Pacific Council in our 19 counties and in Northwest Oregon and Southwest Washington are joining us. It's just super fantastic. We're super excited to have you all join us. And of course, these episodes are recorded. They'll be placed on our website, and you'll have the links to them. For those of you who are in the Cascade Pacific Council, you actually receive a newsletter on Thursdays, and all of the links that you have in today's webinar will be there as well. But you know, we do these really so you can just sort of tune in and listen at your leisure, or you can watch at your leisure, whatever is easiest for you. So that's really our objective here. So just let's go over some of the latest news and happenings and some of the awesomeness that's happening around the Cascade Pacific Council here. First of all, some friendly reminders of, you know, COVID-19 is still here and we're still working through it and whatnot, but by golly, scouts have been scouting safely. It's just super fantastic to see all of these great events where new scouts are joining us and joining in the fun and having a great time, and we're doing it safely. So thanks so much to all for all of the hard work you've been putting into this and all the hard work you're doing just to keep everybody scouting and keep these kids active. And so just a couple of reminders that everyone, including vaccinated individuals, are required to wear a face covering indoors at all times and outdoors when you can't social distance. So make sure you're doing that, and it'll keep everybody safe and whatnot. And social distancing is 6 feet as required by the state and counties and whatnot between individuals. So please do that. Also, just keep chatting with your scout leaders and scout units and your parents involved and whatnot, and just make sure that everybody's, you know, okay with what we're working through here, and just make sure everybody's comfortable. That's really, really the key. All right, some news and deadlines around the Cascade Pacific Council. Just wanted to go through these with you. And again, you'll have links to these in your email. For those of you who are on our email newsletter, you'll receive these. So October 14th, our Cascade Pacific Council Summit and District Roundtables. For those of you who are new, these are monthly meetings in which we just sort of go over everything that's happening around the area. It's a great place to just connect with other scouters and other parents and other leaders and just hearing what's going on and just having some great discussions. It's really fantastic. Some of these are virtual meetings. Some of these are in person. The summit itself is really the opening that we at the council conduct, just to give you the latest around the council, just give you updates around really covering kind of all the topics, including some of the ones we talk about on our weekly basis. But then after that, we break out into district roundtables, and those are fun. You get to meet some parents and folks from your area and chat about scouting. So that's going to be happening on October 14th, and we'll send emails around to all those members in the Cascade Pacific Council. You'll get emails on that with links and everything. Also, October 15th through 17th is World Scouting has this thing called Jamboree on the Air, Jamboree on the Internet. So it is scouts from all over the world are meet up and they chat and talk. And it is a fantastic way to just see what scouting's impact is around the world. It is just absolutely amazing. Actually, there is a goal for World Scouting to conduct 4 billion hours of service over the next few years. It's amazing. Actually, 2 billion hours already. So fantastic stuff. You can go to scout.org to find out more information on that. And October 21st, just so you know, for those of you who have been doing summer of service, you've been doing service activities, the deadline for submitting that information is October 21st. On November 1st, is our deadline for summer camp Lost and Found. So if you've lost anything from a water bottle to a t-shirt and whatnot, make sure you check that out. You can go to our website and I'll show you some links on that and how to find that here in just a moment. But that deadline is November 1st. And November 6th is the Virtual University of Scouting. You can find this actually all on our website here. Let's actually go there real quick here. Let's see if we can. Give me 1 second here. We'll actually go here real quick. I'll just give you a little quick overview here. is you'll find out this information. So I just want you to check it out here. You can go to the navigation. Adventures is all about the adventures that happen around the Cascade Pacific Council. Programs are all the programs themselves from Cub Scouts, Scouts BSA. You can check those out. But here is the information on Lost and Found. You can click on that under Tools, under Lost and Found there. That's where you'll find that. And so you click on that. And if you've, again, like if you've lost a water bottle or whatnot, just come here and you can fill out this little form here. And it's just a little request form. We have the deadline here of November 1st. So make sure you fill that out. Let us know what you're missing. And we'll go through that. Also, what I was mentioning before is the Jamboree on the Air, Jamboree on the Internet website. Yeah, you'll see this in your email, but you can go to jota.info, jota.info, or you can go to scout.org and they'll have links to it there. But it's a really incredible event. It's really, really fun to just meet scouts from around the world. You can see here, it's the world's largest digital scouting event taking place online and over the air. The educational event brings together more than 2 million scouts every year for a weekend of scouting and friendship. Just really neat to see that scouts are all over the world doing fantastic things. So check that out. All right, let's get back to this here. Don't want to forget that October 31st is your deadline to enjoy the Scout Shop sale here, where you can get 25% off uniform bottoms, that's shorts and pants, with the purchase of a uniform top. So check that out. And also, just want to let you know that weekend camping reservations are now open. And as a matter of fact, check this out. On Merriweather, Camp Merriweather, there are some weekends that are opening up, and that's going to be available to you on Friday at noon from our website. And you can go to Tentaroo. The Tentaroo forms there for those of you who have made reservations in the past. For those of you who are new, chat with your scout leader about what this means and how you can make reservations, because we do have a few weekends open for off-season. We call it off-season camping when it is camping, not around summer camp time. So it's called off-season camping. Anyway, so great opportunities to check out our camps year-round and take your unit out camping. Also, there are weekend horse rides for scouts and families. Winter camping opportunities also are opening at noon this Friday. Now, remember, you're going to get this all in email on Thursday. So make sure you check your email because we'll have links to that. And so this is going to open up on Friday. But for now, you can actually chat with your scout leaders and your fellow parents. Say, hey, do we want to go to winter camping? It's fantastic. A great way to just have some fun at our amazing cabins in near Mount Hood. So really fantastic. Also, of course, Summer Camp 2022 reservations are open as well. You can check all that out in your email and on our website and on Facebook, of course. And lastly here, a couple quick things here for those of you who are having join nights events or just want to promote your scout unit because you're meeting. There's lots of great recruiting tools at cpcbsa.org/recruiting. We've got yard signs and these fun banners and whatnot. You can get those. Also, I just want to let people know and kind of emphasize this because, hey, as your local marketing guy, I just want us to just spread the great word about the awesome things we're doing in the community. And this is kind of an old school approach, but by gosh, we just want to have signs out there saying, hey, we are out here serving your community, whether it's doing a cleanup or an Eagle project, whatever it is. We have these really wonderful, they're huge banners. They're like 3 foot by 6 foot. You can hang those up between a couple of trees as you're doing your cleanups and whatnot. It's just a neat way to show that, you know, we scouts are out here doing our thing and serving your community. So you can order those at cpcbsa.org/recruiting as well. Also, one other way to promote your scout unit is through a website, of course, and through a Facebook page, of course, as well. But we've got this neat thing going on with the folks at Wix, who are a website design development company. It's basically an easy way to build a website. You can check it out at wix.com, but you can go to cpcbsa.org/WIX. If you're interested in doing this, we're trying to get enough units together who want to do this so we can sign up for it. And it gives us a great deal of basically half price and a free custom domain for your scout troop for a year. It's really, really great. Scout pack or troop. And it's really just an awesome way to promote your unit as well. And just showcase your great photos and all of that for, especially for folks who are not on Facebook, if you're don't have a Facebook page. So check that out. All right, let's actually dive in here because we've got some great tools here I wanted to share with you. We went over this a bit last week, and here's what's fantastic is we just got some really wonderful feedback. So we have actually changed our quick start guide and our page. So I'm going to pull up my browser here, and we're actually just going to go straight straight to the page. We'll go back to the homepage here of the Cascade Pacific Council website. And for those of you who haven't seen it, or you have friends who want to know what we're all about, by golly, it's a fun way to see just all the great adventures, grit, and growth you get here in the Cascade Pacific Council of the Boy Scouts of America. Just a really, really fun. But for those of you who are new, for you new Scout parents especially, all you have to do is you can actually scroll down here and you can go to this new to scouting and you can go to get started here. It goes to the Quick Start guide or cpcbsa.org/quickstart. If we type in that, we will go to this page. I'm just going to walk everybody through this real quick here, just so you can see what's available to you. And really, this is for new parents. So parents in Cub Scouts and parents in Scouts BSA or the older Scout units, Scout crews and whatnot. You can check this out too, because we just want to give you a little overview for those of you who are new to Scouting. It's hopefully some good tools here. We call the 10 essentials to adventure, grit, and growth. And we're trying to keep this short and sweet, and have a great way for you to basically really quickly understand some of the things of how to get started in scouting. So while it may seem like a lot, there is a lot you can do in scouting, but hopefully this is kind of a little checklist for you to dive on in and get started quickly. So literally step one here, we've got a little overview video from National Boy Scouts of America on Cub Scouting. You can check that out. Step two is getting a uniform and a book. And like I mentioned, you can actually go to get the deal at our Northwest Scout Shop here. You can click on this and it takes you to the Northwest Scout Shop page, and you can get all the contact info here for the Scout Shop. We have, you can give them a call. They're actually in downtown Portland and they will help you really with anything you need when it comes to your Scout uniform and all of that. Super helpful. We've got the hours here. We're open of when we're open and closed and whatnot. So you can just get all the information right here at the Northwest Scout page. And you can actually find that also under the About link here in the website. So that's really, really important. And they're just fantastic on really guiding you through, you know, what's great about the uniforms and whatnot. You actually see here, so we've got, for those of you who are new, we have tops and bottoms to the uniforms. A lot of Scout units wear the bottoms. Some are optional, but there are great. Boy, the material these days is fantastic. It is more flexible and breathable than ever, so it's great for just sort of active wear. But the pants themselves and the shorts or whatnot, well, I tell you, if you've got young kids, they are great. Let the kids trash on their Scout pants because they are indestructible. The Scout pants are fantastic, and they're really, really great. We've had kids who are wearing those ever since they were little, and let them run around in those things all the time. So really great stuff. So check that out. And you get 24% off now. So that's really fantastic. We also have a uniform bank, which is really great if you need to get a used, if you are okay with getting a used uniform, or know some folks who would rather prefer to get a uniform for free. They can actually do that at the uniform bank and make a request at our uniform bank. You can do that too. Also, our step three here is really connecting with your parents and leaders. What we have here is we've got this little sheet here. It's a little one sheet. I'm going to click on this and we'll open it up here. And what it is it's just a quick little guide in what you can, let's open it here. Just with your contact information and whatnot, when your unit meets, when your Cub Scout pack meets, what the location is, you can just fill this out, print it out at your leisure. But that's a really great, just quick little guide for those who are starting out here. It just sort of keeps all the details in one spot, which is really, really fantastic. And for unit leaders, if you can use that too and share that with folks, that's great too. Your next step is taking youth protection training. This is a program here. There's a how-to guide here. This is one fantastic tool that we in the Boy Scouts of America have here about youth protection. It is incredible. You'll actually see this at the beginning of each of your Scout books too. So like I said about getting a uniform, you also want to get a book too. And what's really, really great about that is each book actually has a guide inside of it about youth protection. And so you'll want to take that training and you'll want to do that. We recommend this really for all adults to go through the training, and it is required for new leaders before any kind of service with a unit. But it's really recommended for all parents. It's just a great way to become familiar with the program itself on youth protection, and great for all concerned. So check that out. You'll also want to get yourself a little familiar with Cub Scouting. There are some just about the program itself. There is so much you can do in the Boy Scouts of America, whether it's Cub Scouts, Scouts BSA, Venturing Crews, Sea Scouting, all of that. And, but you know, you can really just want to come familiar with it. There's this great link here from scouting.org. We'll just go there real quick here, show you what this is all about. And it has a lot of great just information about being a new family, what the program is about, the different kinds of activities, and how Cub Scouting is organized, how to get involved, all of that. So really great resources here from scouting.org, from the Boy Scouts of America. So you'll want to check that out too. And you can just go as deep as you want or not. It can be daunting. I know when starting a new activity of any kind of activity, whether it's sports or scouts or anything like that, or theater, it can be just so much to have to feel like you have to learn, but you don't have to here. Just look at the basics or anything you want to grow into and learn more about. It's all right here. It's really, really fantastic, excellent information. So there's that. And the other thing we want to talk about here is learning about Cub camping. And what we have here is we are so lucky, so blessed to have just these incredible, incredible camps here. There's a link down here, but there's also up here at Adventures. You can click on, go over to summer camps. You can look at Cub Scout camps. We have Butte Creek Scout Ranch, Camp Clark. I mean, these are incredible, incredible places where you get to start your scouting adventure with your kids. And we highly recommend that you know, adults get involved too. Join us for these camps. They are fantastic. I'm in a scout troop, and I love it when the parents can come with us and just have a great time and see the kids in action. It is fantastic. So check that out. And we'd like to also talk about Camp for All as our fundraising program that focuses specifically on camp and camp programs, camp properties, all that. And we just want to thank all of our supporters for helping us out there. It's really great. If you want to learn more, you can go to the Camp for All page or at cpcbsa.org/campforall. Learn about that. It's incredible. We're really just so grateful to have all the support there. Next step is to download a family guide. We have English or Spanish versions of that. I'll just show you one of these real quick. Like, we'll open this up. And this is great because it has just, again, it's an overview about what it's like to be a new Cub Scout family, why people join. These are great tools to also send to your friends. If you have a friend or your son or daughter has friends who might be interested in joining in the adventure, this is a great place to send them to. It just sort of talks about all about scouting and gives you kind of an overview. You can print this out or just look at it at your leisure, save it onto your desktop. Either way, just a really great tool on getting started. You'll also want to get a medical checkup. This is just to be prepared for the year, because it's great to have these at the ready. They're good for a year. So if you're planning on doing summer camp, there's a links here to download and fill out your medical forms and whatnot. You also, the next step nine is inviting a friend. As I mentioned, you can actually go to this page here. We say, it's really a great place to check out these pictures and videos and whatnot. And you can actually download these. You could share these videos. You can text people pictures here that you see on this page. We've got all these great images and whatnot. You can also, of course, share things from our Facebook page and whatnot too, and text those to a friend and say, boy, we're starting this awesome thing. We'd love to have you join us. Really fun to do it with starting out with friends, because of course, you're also in scouting, going to build lifelong friendships too. So it's really, really great. Also, connect with us and stay informed. Really, we've got our email newsletter. If you are a member of the Cascade Pacific Council, when you join, you actually do receive this newsletter. You go into our email newsletter system and we send you emails. So make sure you get that. You can also get text updates if you want. And just check your email for that newsletter. It comes out on Thursdays, like we said, around noon. And so you want to check that out. And connect with us on Facebook and Instagram, LinkedIn, of course. We've got lots of great things we like to share there, stories and whatnot. And that's it. So there's your 10 steps to get started as a new Cub Scout family, new Cub Scout parents. Check that out here at the Quick Start Guide. Okay, so for Scouts BSA, very similar things. For those of you, especially if you've not been in Cub Scouts and it is new to you, you have all the links here too. We've got a little overview video. We've got a uniform and book information here as well. How to connect with your leaders and parents and whatnot. That's next step. Step four is take your youth protection training. Again, step-by-step guide for that is right here. Really, really simple. It does take a bit of time though to walk through it, but it is fantastic and really great. Recommended for all parents to go through it, and because it just gets you familiar with the youth protection program that is incredible. Also, I will mention too that you can actually look here at about and throughout our website here, you can go to youth protection. You can find out more about that here too on the website. So that's really great. Get your medical checkups. You can do that too, because again, you're most likely going to go to camp or do any kind of activity that's over 72 hours. And that means you need a medical form, and there are different parts of that. You can actually check that out at scouting.org. Well, let's actually go there just real quick here so you can get familiar with what it is, because there are always forms and because of safety measures and whatnot. So we just want you to make sure you get the latest and greatest. We link to the scouting page here at scouting.org, and you can actually download the forms here. If you're going to camp, you download the forms here. Super, super simple. Or as you get older and in scouting and want to go on these incredible other adventures outside of summer camp here in the CPC, by golly, check out all the high adventure camps that that the Boy Scouts of America has. It is incredible, from Northern Tier to Philmont, just some incredible high adventure opportunities. Summit Bechtel Reserve is just an incredible experience. So you'll want to check that out as well. Okay, so lastly here we have, or almost lastly, gear up, prepare for adventure. Don't forget, your Scout Handbook really has a pile of resources, so many wonderful, incredible resources there. It is fantastic. It's funny, it's fun as somebody who's been in scouting for a long time to see the differences in the books themselves, but the basics have been the same, by gosh, as to what kind of gear you need, what kind of resources you need to have fun and enjoy scouting. It's all there. You'll also find gear lists in your Scout Handbook, or you can download gear checklists at the Scout Life website and shop for a lot of it at your Northwest Scout Shop, not just uniforms and whatnot, but actual gear too. So, and oftentimes have great deals. So check that out. All right. Lastly, of course, the same thing as with Cub Scouts is connect with us and stay informed. That's really, really important and really key. To just make sure you're checking your email for the newsletter, because that has the links to everything that we talk about in these webinars and whatnot. It also has all the updates and deadlines and things of that nature that are important. We try to be really good about not spamming you and sending you just tons and tons of emails, but we do send emails occasionally, not just weekly, just because there's lots of important things and deadlines and updates and whatnot. So make sure you check your email out for that. And of course, you can always come to the website at cpcbsa.org. We have lots of information here. Everything is here as well. And you can always, you know, as you can see up here on the website, you can always call us or toss us an email too. If you have questions or you're feeling a little lost, we'll connect you with the right people and make sure you you get what you need all the time. So those are your top 10 essentials, your 10 essentials for getting started in Cub Scouts or for Scouts BSA parents. Hopefully this has been fairly easy to digest. You can see it again at cpcbsa.org/quickstart, and that will direct you right to this page. I hope this is pretty easy to digest. And you can, as you join us in scouting, you'll learn that there are so many fantastic opportunities to get involved, to grow in scouting, to grow in leadership. The opportunities are incredible for parents and adults as well as kids. You'll see some of that actually here. If you toy around on the website, you'll see lots of different kinds of events, and you'll see lots of different tools here. The tools themselves are all about just all the different leadership opportunities. You'll see training for adult leaders, training for youth leaders. There are some incredible programs you cannot find anywhere else here in the Boy Scouts of America and in the Cascade Pacific Council. We're so, so lucky, so blessed to have so many volunteers who help us out and present these programs, who love scouting and help adults and kids alike just grow in scouting and grow in leadership and enjoy those opportunities. So I hope that covers everything. I believe that covers everything in the Quick Start guide. So again, cpcbsa.org/quickstart is where you want to go for that information, and you'll get all the links there. And again, check your email for that. Let's see, I think that's all we're going to cover today. And as we always say here in the Cascade Pacific Council and the Boy Scouts of America, you know, we always say grit starts here when you start scouting with us, and then As you grow in scouting, all that grit you learn, by golly, it lasts forever. Well, thanks so much for joining us. Hope that that helps you. For all of you new parents who are starting out, hope that gives you some guidance and some tools there to get you started again. If you ever have questions, by gosh, connect with us through the website, and we'd love to help. Thanks so much for joining us, and have yourself a fantastic day, and we will see you next week.